All right, so I'm coming back with a little bit more Squadrons gameplay. I know it's supposed to be Dark Souls night, but I'm wanting to just relax tonight. Did a little bit too much fun last night, and just trying to recover from it a little bit. So we're just going to go ahead and play some Squadrons and just relax and chill. If me using VR is a little disorienting for some people, just please say so, and I can always get that taken off. And we're just gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna focus on multiplayer gameplay. No, we'll go ahead and continue the story where we left off. Kind of warm up with that and just kind of go from there. The real trick, though, is trying to remember whenever I set something down where I set it. All right, we got a briefing to go to. Oh, Gunny and Keo has something to say.
The Empire won't push into our territory again anytime soon.
Thanks to our new pilot.
Yeah, and thanks to the rest of us. This isn't a race, all right? We're a team.
You're right, Gunny. But still, nice flying out there.
Speaking of fancy flying, I was thinking about the Dragon Void run from a few years back. You see that one, Keo?
Oh, sure. I caught the whole thing on the HoloNet.
Yeah, me too. I watched the entire thing, but for the life of me, I can't recall who won.
I think it was one of the Ash twins?
No, wait. Dellan Voos.
Yeah, that's it. Boy, he was something else back then. In fact, the only pilot I've seen that comes close since is Keo here.
Oh, come on. Dellan Voos got 9 championships under his belt. I've only got 5.
That's still a good number.
Commander Javes has someone special.
Hello and welcome to the stream.
Briefing room. Let's get in there and find out what's next.
Okay.
So where is it now?
I helped Talus Group chase it away from a medical convoy towards Yavin. It's pinned in the upper atmosphere with no hyperdrive, but too many fighters for Talus Group to handle alone.
This might work out for both of us. Come, meet a visitor.
Wedge Antilles, Rogue Squadron. I hear you're the reason I was able to finally get a comm through. I have a Star Destroyer problem that Vanguard might be able to help me solve.
Hello.
We need a Star Destroyer for Project Starhawk, intact. Now we prove what Vanguard's made of. Wedge, if you would.
Okay. So, looks like we're gonna have almost... Oh, should have... Yep, the whole squad's gonna be coming in.
As you may have overheard, Talus Group has cornered the Imperial Star Destroyer Victorum above the planet Yavin. They're in tough, but it's presented a great opportunity for us to jump in and not only disable that Star Destroyer, but to seize control. So first, we need to give ourselves some cover by knocking out the turrets.
Okay.
Naturally, if we can also take out the targeting system, that'll buy us even more time. Next, we need to prepare the Star Destroyer for boarding. We'll need to find a potential breach point in the Victorum's hull, preferably near the bridge. Once you find a good spot, bombard it until the hull is breached. However, we can expect that the Victorum still has plenty of TIE fighters. They will try to stop us. Once the skies are clear, we can bring in the boarding team. While our troops capture the bridge, Vanguard will defend the exterior from reinforcements. Once the boarding team has seized the bridge and is in control of the Star Destroyer, we'll rendezvous with the Temperance. Okay, I think I accidentally made stealing a Star Destroyer sound simple. Let's hope it is.
I mean, should be relatively simple. What have you got to say,
Sorry
Wedge?
Sorry for the speedy introduction. But Talus Group was counting on me to get reinforcements first. Your commander says you have talent. Enough to steal a Star Destroyer and get away with it. Normally, I'd have Rogue Squadron for this. But General Syndulla gave me a temporary assignment to Project Starhawk. Meanwhile, Rogue is handling... well, that's classified too. General Syndulla keeps us busy. Your commander and I have something in common. I once flew for the Empire too. At Skystrike Academy. Turning to the Rebellion was the smartest move I ever made. I wish more of my friends had done the same. Look, I appreciate the talk, but Talus Group's waiting for us.
That's right. I remember now. Luke was initially going to go to Skystrike Academy, but then he got stuck helping out on the farm. Wedge ended up going, and then... That's right. Okay. I wonder how the series would have changed had Luke gone.
Aren't you tossing them in the deep end a little early, Lyndon?
Vanguard can handle it. Can't you? Besides, Project Starhawk needs that Star Destroyer for... Well, you know. Wedge made a name for himself at the Battle of Yavin. He knows that system better than the Empire ever will. You'll be fighting on the Rebellion's old turf. So if Wedge has any advice, you'd be smart to listen.
You know, a wounded Krakana can still bite. Just watch yourself around that Star Destroyer, huh?
Oh, absolutely.
As you can.
Oh, just notice we have three people in the stream. Hello and welcome, everybody.
We're headed to Yavin. In exalted company, it seems.
And now we know Project Starhawk needs an Imperial Star Destroyer. That's enough firepower to tackle a small fleet, or a means to catch the Empire off guard. But that wouldn't warrant all this secrecy. There must be more to the Commander's plan. We'll just have to trust him. Too bad there isn't an easier way to get what we need. Even a damaged Star Destroyer has deck upon deck of Durasteel plating, turrets, shields. My poor bigoted father called Star Destroyers the fists of the Empire. He wasn't wrong. But they can be beaten. If you're good. And lucky. Let's stay optimistic.
Yeah.
To Yavin, then. Let's not delay.
Alright. Anybody else to talk to? No. Alright.
The commander wants you in an X-Wing for this mission. Got you outfitted with ion missiles. They disable enemy fighters and they'll disable subsystems on enemy capital ships too.
Okay. Would like a little bit of a better engine, but...
Fire! You're popular today. Roger. Don't stay in the clouds too long. Even this high up, the heat's gonna strip your hull.
There we are. Yeah, I know. I was just... Thank you for... How many type of... There he is. How close that was setting us to the...
We need to make a few repairs, then get ourselves out of here.
Roger that, Talos leader. But don't worry about the Imperials. We'll keep them busy.
You're really gonna steal that Star Destroyer?
That's the plan. Okay, Vanguard, on me. Let's head for the Victorum.
Alright, where are you at, Wedge? Over here. Gotcha.
Focus your shields before they open fire on us.
I just did.
Knock out its targeting system.
Let's do it.
Putting power to forward shields. Damage, and this thing still has teeth.
No wonder Talos took a beating just chasing it here. I wanted to see the Victorum go up in flames, but stealing it, I like that even better. They've locked onto my ship.
All right.
Internal systems. Scan for a breach point so we can send an aborting team.
Yep.
You're up, Five.
Breaching a Star Destroyer, just like the old days.
Look out, Vanguard!
Here! We can send the team in here!
Imperial fighters incoming. Get a punch, Malia!
Yep, I'm trying to.
Last fighters back. Clear the skies.
Alright. Where? There we are.
That interceptor's on me. Can't shake him. Back on Five. Help him out.
Where are you at, Frisk?
Just keep coming. I'm in a real bind here.
Yeah, I'm trying to find you. Where are you at?
I got him. Shields at zero. Enemy is persistent.
You set him up, I'll knock him down.
Yes. Thanks, Mike. I owe you one. Let's stop those fighters.
How about that game of Sabacc you were talking about? Wedge, do you really want to just float around while we're still waiting for them to take over? Take out the cruiser, that should stop any future reinforcements from their people.
Boarding team here, we secured the breach point.
Nice. Ion missiles are great against shields.
We're wearing the carrier down. Keep at it. Almost there, Vanguard. Take that carrier down. We're taking fire, but we're almost to the bridge. Phew. Carrier destroyed. Final. Let's finish off the rest. Bridge is sealed! Cutting through the blast doors!
Oh. Well, that's one of ours. There we are. Got a knock at my door.
Are Oh no, I'm just, it seems like a search hidden here too. So I'll have to double check that.
Okay, and I am, I am back. Yeah, I know, I'm out of play area. I'm sitting back down. Calm down, system. There we go. No, I don't want to abort. I just wanted to pause so I could take care of that. Friend is starting a new job at a company, and they just wanted me to look over some of their, some of the contract stuff and go over that. The wording was a little bit confusing, but it was pretty bog standard basic. So, no, I'm not abandoning the mission. Why do you want me to try to do that? Anyways, where was I? Ah, TIE fighters. Oh, bombers. Oh, no.
Pay my debts. Eventually.
And that just leaves you. Alright, so what have we got left? Understood. You might notice a little bit of wiggle. I'm just, every now and then, the headset does adjust a little bit wonkily. So I'm, every now and then it does, I'm trying to get stick to right at this position for me. There we go. Yeah, we're still following you, Wedge. Oh.
We've got another Imperial carrier.
Make that two.
Make that three carriers.
Shit.
That's a lot. Get ready, everyone. We're in. Taking control. Star Destroyer's taken down its own carrier. What a sight! Yes! The ship is ours! You actually did it!
Oh, wow.
And Project Starhawk has a Star Destroyer.
Vanguard. I'll escort Talos Group to safe harbor. Great work. General Syndulla will be impressed. Wedge, out.
Well, let's see, we didn't... Okay, that was a little bit of weird buzzing. We didn't die that time, so that's good. What do you want, Keo?
Now that was a fun mission. Even better than beating my time on the Death March circuit. We got to steal a Star Destroyer and help our friends doing it. And see Yavin! We still have allies on the fourth moon, but I've never been there. There was an energy at Yavin like I've never felt anywhere else. It was chaotic and serene all at once. The Empire corrupts the energy of every planet it touches. But I can always feel the good buried beneath that. And that's what we fight for, the good. Anyway, I saw Frisk bothering Commander Javes earlier. Knowing Frisk, the commander might appreciate some backup.
Okay.
Now the Empire's gonna want that Star Destroyer back. Good. Let's see them try and take it. You know, back home, after the Empire invaded Mimbin, we stole an armored transport hauler full of scout walkers. When the Empire came looking for them, we just turned the walkers against them. Had a real good time. I'm guessing the commander has something similar in mind for this Star Destroyer, right? Otherwise, what's the point? At least Wedge picked the right team for the job, huh? Those slackers in Alphabet Squadron would still be fapping around at Yavin.
The other thing could also be Star Destroyers have some pretty...
Time to check with the commander and see what's next.
Star Destroyers do have some pretty... potent bombardment lasers. Oh, wait. Gonk droid? Okay. Interesting.
Not now, Frisk. I'll answer your questions once the Star Destroyer has been delivered safely.
Delivered where? We risked our tails to get that Star Destroyer. You can't even tell us where we're going.
It's not my call. Besides, I'd be risking a lot of lives if I shared too much too soon.
You hearing this? After all we did for Project Starhawk.
I mean, we did one step. That's not too much yet.
It's the basics.
Lander, our soldiers on the Star Destroyer Victorum just sent a code yellow.
Now? Damn. Call in Vanguard for immediate briefing.
Ah, heck. It was just getting good.
Okay. God damn. The other drawback
time to get you briefed
to this headset, sometimes the cables get a little bit weird on you. It'd be nice if the PSVR was fully wireless.
The Star Destroyer you captured has unexpectedly fallen out of hyperspace behind enemy lines.
Oh shit.
Our troops are repairing the hyperdrive as quickly as possible, but you need to buy them some time. There's an Imperial fleet advancing toward the Star Destroyer Victorum. I want A-Wings intercepting enemy fighters. The rest of Vanguard will provide defense and support. I know Imperial protocol better than most. I have no doubt the Empire will disable the Victorum with ion weapons before sending shuttles to recapture it. Stop them at all costs. The Empire must not reclaim the Victorum. Once the Star Destroyer's hyperdrive is operational, cover its escape so it can jump to safety. I'll send you rendezvous coordinates when the time is right.
Okay. What's up, Gunny?
I remember the first time I was trapped behind enemy lines. It was the Battle of Mimbin, the first year of the Clone Wars. The Separatists had dropped a battalion of B-2 droids on the Nan Flatlands, cutting us off from the 224th Clone Division. A thunderstorm was jamming communications, so I took a skyhopper to rendezvous with the 224, hoping to get some reinforcements. It didn't go well. I was halfway across the flatlands when those droids shot me down. And believe me, you have never seen a finer crash landing. The only problem was, My arm got caught in some wreckage.
Oh, I just noticed.
I'd rather live my life with one arm than sit around and wait for those droids to find me. Besides, you only need one hand to carry a blaster, right? I dragged myself out of those flatlands with only one arm and a seriously sour disposition. I guarantee those clone boys had never seen anything like me before, but they fixed me up. Then they helped us drive those blasted droids right off planet. If only I'd known that 3 years later, those clones would be replaced by stormtroopers. But anyway, we should head back to the hangar. The Victorum needs us.
Yeah. Shit. That just, her arm blends right in with the jumpsuit.
I underestimated the repairs. Now the whole project's at risk.
Hyperdrives break, Otto. It's not your fault.
They should have suggested you send more engineers to Yavin. And this never would have happened.
It's fine. Vanguard is ready. They'll get there in time. Won't you?
I know. But I'll reach out to Hosnian Prime and requisition a few more engineers. Just in case.
Get moving, pilot.
All right. Oh. Frisk and Keo are chatting.
We were just talking about what happened to the Victorum, and Keo had one of those... what do you call them?
It's just a hunch, Frisk, that's all.
So what do you think happened?
I feel like it was the Imperials. They probably sabotaged the hyperdrive before our soldiers could get them off the ship.
That would make sense.
I know it sounds wild, but when Keo has a hunch, they're usually right.
Don't listen to him. It's really not that big of a deal. On Miriel, we're taught to respect and listen to the Force. I can't reach out and touch it like others could, but sometimes I just have a feeling about things. I don't like to talk about it. These days, you never know who in the galaxy is listening.
Now, let's get serious, huh? When are you gonna have a premonition about the Carillion lottery?
Really? People are waiting for us to save them, and you're thinking about credits.
Look, you see any numbers, just tell me, okay? They gotta be good for something.
You really should get going.
I like Frisk. Ooh.
A-wings go as fast as you can fly them. Their hull and shields are too light to take on capital ships, but Imperial starfighters won't stand a chance with you in this cockpit.
Okay. Oh, I can customize it?
We have a few options to make your TIE hunting more efficient. Big fan of the rapid-fire lasers and barrage rockets myself.
We'll go ahead and stick at the... See, barrage rockets. Don't really care too much for those. Let's see. We already have pretty low health. But the overload shield could probably be... Oh, but then there's that. What about our engine?
Guaranteed to satisfy.
I'll take a hit to maneuverability for double our acceleration speed. Alright.
You got it.
Yeah. This might actually make me a little bit more comfortable flying an A-Wing. So it looks like over the course of all the missions, they'll have us fly everything.
What happened here? Who cares? Our Star Destroyer's in trouble.
Vanguard, good to see you again. Think you can keep those bombers off us?
We're on it, Victorum. Sit tight.
Until you arrive.
your controls, or worse.
Back to all enemies.
All bombers destroyed.
Great. Just need time to restart our systems.
Work fast. Imperial shuttles headed your way.
Hold them off. If even one Imperial shuttle reaches us, we'll be overwhelmed.
You heard him, Vanguard. Intercept those shuttles.
We should split up to take them down.
All right.
Hit it!
On it. You handle the other shuttle.
I'm with you.
Oh, I see. They're being smart. They're going through that wreckage.
We can't let a single shuttle board the Victoria. I'm taking fire. Another shuttle group incoming. They have ties in tow.
Attack that!
Alright, and that should be enough for a lock. Take out these carriers while they're sitting here, because they're just going to keep pooping out star or TIE fighters against us. Oh, that's exactly what I was thinking.
I'm calling in Y-Wing support. They'll lead a bombing run on those carriers. Don't let any TIE fighters hear them.
We need you fighting TIEs.
All right, Y-Wings are here.
Vanguard, right. We lose our bombers, we're done for.
Where's our bombers?
I'm breaking off to intercept their fighters.
I'll help out our bomber backup.
Watch your tails, those TIEs have missiles.
See you later.
All right, where is did that? There he is.
This isn't fun.
Thank you, Gunny, for the resupply.
That's one carrier down. Great start.
I'm really trying. They just... That should have him down.
I'm on your side.
Oh. There's... That should be all of them.
That's the last of them. Your timing couldn't be better. We're almost done. Our bombers are out of here. Thanks for the backup.
Okay.
We're doing our final test, Vanguard. Spread out and keep watch. Nice moves back there, Keo. You gotta teach the rest of the squadron that drift.
You wanna learn right now?
I'll watch five figure it out first.
Okay, follow me.
Oh.
I learned this racing in the Koshi Star Circuit. First, transfer all power to your engines and fly as fast as you can. Yes, now we're gonna buzz the bridge of the Victorum. Be ready to boost.
Okay.
Boost is ready. Punch it! When you're ready, turn as hard as you can, then hold the booster to cut your engines.
All right!
Yes! You got it, Five!
Hey, what's buzzing our bridge? Someone the Empire's never gonna catch again.
Sorry, team. It's for the greater good of the New Republic.
I'll, practice drifting later, without spectators.
Operational, Vanguard. What do you say we get out of here?
Regrouping on your position, Victorum.
Here I am.
Okay, now I'm actually starting to understand the whole drifting thing. Should be the last bomber right there.
Nice shot.
targeting system flush. How long should this take?
Longer than I'd like.
Okay.
Backup radar just arrived. Fire, destroy the radar.
There's too many fighters.
Triple lasers are back online. Hyperdrive's nearly ready.
On your way.
Oh shoot, my shields are completely down. That's the only drawback, is I can't do my normal thing on...
Can you hold them off a little longer? Didn't come this far just to leave you hanging. It's now or never,
these.
Vanguard. Protect the Victorum.
You know, we'll sacrifice speed and to be able to keep our shields up and running. You guys focus on that, I'll take care of the bombers. This is starting to get kind of rough. I was kind of hoping that a little bit of friendly collision would go on there.
Just do it.
Okay.
That's a hit.
All right, so
powering up hyperdrive systems now, Vanguard.
I think this is going to gradually ease us into fleet battles. Raider's gone.
You have the new jump coordinates, Vanguard?
Yep.
See you on the other side, Victor.
Oh, wow. Just in time, too. As a rebel is a shield.
This is where the boss keeps his secret project. Who'd want to get this close to the Ringali Nebula?
I believe that is the idea.
Oh. So my thought process here might be right. They're cutting apart the Star Destroyers to get their weapons. Would make sense. Put them on something bigger, bulkier, and
that's why we've been gathering Imperial ships to build this.
We call it the Starhawk, and it's going to help us end this war.
General Syndulla.
Hello, Vanguard. Welcome to the Nadiri dockyards. I'd give you the tour, but the Empire knows we're up to something now. They'll be looking for us, which means we have work to do.
Ooh, we're switching over to the Empire. I think. Not even close. Raider Wrecker. Let's see. Yeah, that one we really didn't get there on. 15 minutes, damn. I mean, if I were set to just story mode.
An old enemy has finally surfaced. One of my spies has linked the attacks on our Star Destroyers with the New Republic Starhawk project. A common factor is Lyndon James. You knew James better than anyone, Captain Carroll.
If I had, I'd have destroyed him before he betrayed us at Fostar Haven.
Then this is your second chance. The rebels are keeping a low profile. Take Titan Squadron, hunt down this Starhawk, and eliminate it.
Gladly, Admiral Sloane. But if I may ask, there's a particular pilot I'd like to requisition.
Okay.
Greg, come in. Is it true we're getting a new pilot?
Copy, sir. Captain Carroll's bringing someone in, John.
The treacherous slime taking our ships. Good.
More the merrier.
Easy, Von Reg. Remember the last time you lost your cool?
The day I cut through a whole squadron of rebels and saved your neck.
Focus. Shen's right. Tighten it up, Saul.
Ooh.
Von Reg. Disable it for the enemy.
This helmet has seen some damage.
Overseer to Titan, finish your inspection. Your new wingmate has arrived.
So,
You're our new wingmate. Welcome to Titan Squadron. I'm Varko Gray, squadron leader. I think they're waiting for you in the briefing room. Better make a good first impression.
Okay.
Welcome home, pilot. It feels like a lifetime since Fostar Haven, doesn't it? One fool betrays his squadron, and loyal officers like us are reassigned in disgrace. I heard they sent you to the Outer Rim. I got the Merim Sector, protecting fuel shipments from petty scoundrels and pirates. The kind of posting that used to end careers. Before Endor. Before Lyndon Javes reappeared. No doubt you've heard. Admiral Sloan has instructed me to hunt that traitor down and end this Project Starhawk. It seemed fitting that I bring you back to help me destroy Lyndon. Your Empire needs you, pilot. Are you willing?
I am.
Good.
Getting back into the
For
fun ships to fly.
For now, you will be flying as Titan III. Let's get to work.
Okay.
One of our spies, Agent Thorne, has discovered vital intelligence on Project Starhawk. Your mission is to extract her from an orbital outpost above Hosnian Prime. Your job is to secure the outpost for our extraction team, who will arrive aboard the shuttle Gladius. Behind enemy lines, you must be precise and swift. We have no room for error, Titan. To gain access, you'll have to eliminate perimeter defenses. Intelligence reports missile platforms defending Hosnian space. Destroy them.
All right, that'll be easy.
The outpost itself is protected by turbo laser cannons on all sides. Evade and eliminate them all. When you've secured the area, you will escort the Gladius to the outpost, and our extraction team will acquire Agent Thorne. Once Thorne is secure, reach your Gozanti cruisers and return to the Overseer. Do not lose our spy under any circumstances. That is all.
All right. Okay, Carol.
Now more than ever, the Empire needs reliable soldiers like Agent Thorne. Like you. Unity is the only path to progress. I trust you are aligned with Admiral Sloan's vision for the Empire. We cannot afford to fracture. Not after Endor. This mission is a vital step towards dismantling the Rebellion. And they are a rebellion. Don't be fooled by their new name. The new Republic will fall, just like the last one. It's time for you to play your part. Get to the hangar. Ready your ship.
Understood. How about you, Sol?
I'm Rella Sol. No need to introduce yourself. I've already reviewed your service record. It's been a long time since you were on the front lines. In days past, a mission like ours would have been afforded every possible resource. Unfortunately, times are tight since Endor. In one battle, we lost our Emperor and gained 100 warring factions. If only Emperor Palpatine hadn't dissolved the Imperial Senate. At least then, senators, like my parents, could have maintained order after Endor. But no. Not that I question the Emperor's decision, of course. But now that he's gone, we must look to the future. And reinstating the Senate would help subdue all of this infighting. We can talk later, perhaps.
Oh. Where are you? Are you my engineer?
Sergeant Wade, chief mechanic and head of the hangar crew. Don't see the appeal in flying myself, but I've been working on TIE since they rolled off the assembly line. Your fighter's in good hands. The Overseer saw some action at Pothor and JL, but it's had a complete inspection and overhaul for this mission, Admiral Sloan's orders. And on my orders, every TIE in this hangar has been serviced and test flown. Tighten half the rivets myself. We're ready. Gotta say, I don't know how you and Titan cope out there. No shields or life support, just whole plating between you and space. It must build character. Never met a TIE pilot who backed down from any challenge, shields or not. I've prepared your starfighter to match the latest Imperial guidelines. But if you've got a preferred component or need something customized, I'll take care of it. Just say the word. Your TIE fighter's ready. Good flying.
There is one component I would like on there. What about you, Shen?
Newcomer. Welcome to Titan.
Ooh.
Call me Shen. Before you ask, helmet stays on, cockpit or not. Too many hard landings. Broken neck. 5-6 times. Cybernetics keep me going. Fight. Fall. Get up. Fight again. All for the Empire.
Damn.
Advice. Don't annoy Von Wreck. Good talk. Another time.
Okay, he's been through some shit. And we're off to annoy Von Wreck.
You're the new arrival. I'm Havina Von Wreck. Titan can always use another pilot, so long as you're good at killing rebels. We're going right into their territory, Hosnian Prime. We'll give those scum just a taste of what it was like at Endor. I was there, you know, when the rebellion murdered our Emperor. Half my squad died trying to defend him. Captain Carol understands. She doesn't lecture me about justifiable force like my other commanders. She knows all I need is a target. Politics are for admirals. I keep it simple. Always shoot to kill. Mess with the squadron, and you mess with me. But do your job, and I'll have your back.
Later. Okay. I like mouse droids, sir. Useless in the right way. Well, they're not necessarily useless.
Classic. Maneuverable. Flexible. Can't take much direct fire, but that's no problem for a skilled pilot.
Yep.
Your loadout, however, is not standard. And again, neither are any of Titan Squadron's missions.
Where's... For us, maneuverability will be key. So we'll have a total of 5% improved maneuverability, but acceleration's gonna take a bit of a hit. Proton. Weak homing, that's not gonna be too good for us. And take a little bit of a heavier hitting. Yeah. Maneuverability, that's our key thing. Speed. That we can live without.
Very good then.
Supply ship has its own hyperdrive to it. So, yeah. Got it. Actually, who's our closest? That is.
Information and ready. Missile defense systems activated. Wipe them out and clear path to the station. Don't take their cannons head on unless you have a death wish.
Probably not too much panic yet. They still think our fighter or their fighters can take us down.
We should take out the shield generator. Without it, the turbo lasers are vulnerable.
Rebel starfighters inbound.
Watch your backs.
Here and ready to go.
And she'll, yeah. There's another one a little bit closer. There's not too many left, I think.
Outpost defenses are critically low. Keep it up.
We'll have to try harder than that.
Oh, God damn it. Why are... Oh, that was annoying. My controller locked up.
coordinates. Thin the herd if you have to.
Should be. Be too big of an issue. A-wings are nice and fragile targets. Something I actually didn't know about the TIEs, so I could have been doing a lot more damage in multiplayer matchups.
They've reached the station. Initiating extraction. Imperial shuttle has landed.
What is...
Damage.
They're hunting you.
so let's hunt them back in kind. That you wing at?
You'll have to try harder than that.
Titan, this is Agent Thorn. Your reputation precedes you. It's good to know my life is in capable hands.
We won't let you down, Agent Thorn. Enemy fighters are finished. Titan Squadron. Regroup with the Gladius.
All right.
We're clear of the station. Cover our escape and escort us to the jump point.
Affirmative, Agent Thorn.
We have Republic corvettes inbound. Move, Titan.
Gladius, change course and keep Agent Thorn safe. Titan 3. Take out those fighters. Protect the shuttle at all costs.
I'm on your way. I'm in formation.
There's an X-Wing back from nowhere. Is there no end to these corvettes? Holy shit.
I'm on your wing. I'm under fire.
Agent Thorn, you're in the clear.
You have my thanks, Titan Squadron. And my respect.
Shuttle Gladius, jump into light speed.
Alright, so what's our next task? Clear out those corvettes or get out?
Squadron, reach the carrier and load up.
Let's leave this wretched system.
More ships inbound.
Damn.
Nice work, Titan 3. You're officially part of the squadron.
They got kind of nuts there. I guess thin the herd. What's that one's requirement? Oh, okay. So yeah. Sure, 75. Oh, so I did destroy one of those. Okay.
Pilot.
Oh, somebody said that in my ear. You?
When Captain Carroll said she was bringing in one more pilot, I didn't know what to expect. I've been flying a long time. This wouldn't be the first squadron I've seen compromised by nepotism. But you did well today, pilot. Most spy extractions end with significantly more casualties. If the team had any reservations about you joining Titan Squadron, you certainly put them to rest. Now let's go. Captain Carroll is waiting.
Alright, nobody else to talk to.
Agent Thorne may not have known the precise location of Project Starhawk, but their intel has pointed us in the right direction.
Then we will proceed as planned.
Oh, hello. Captain, is this the new pilot?
Yes. A valuable addition to the squadron, wouldn't you say?
Indeed. Marvelous work securing Agent Thorne. You've exceeded your previous statistics by... Oh, forgive me. I'm so familiar with your profile that I forgot we haven't actually met. I'm LT-514, Imperial Intelligence. I'm eager to analyze your performance in the upcoming mission. Captain Carroll, shall we proceed with the briefing?
Agent Thorne's intel has paid off. We've learned that a convoy of New Republic engineers is traveling from Hosnian Prime to Project Starhawk's secret base. Their chartered path leads them straight through the contested territory of DeSevro. According to our new information, the convoy will attempt to conceal its presence in a local debris field. Follow the convoy through the wreckage and allow them to jump to hyperspace. We will calculate all possible destinations along their trajectory to find Project Starhawk. You must not be detected. We cannot risk losing this convoy. Local Imperial forces have been advised not to interfere. Once the convoy is clear of the debris, it will leave the system, pointing us toward their hidden headquarters. Once we have their jump vector, return to the Overseer and prepare for immediate redeployment.
Okay.
I've already contacted the Imperial authorities at DeSevro. They're aware of the situation.
You're certain he won't interfere? My records indicate that Captain Amos is trigger-happy, to say the least. His fleet is already in ruins after initiating several battles that were frankly quite unnecessary.
Captain Amos is... enthusiastic. I'm hoping he's not a fool. The Empire can't afford to lose assets at this stage in the war.
I agree wholeheartedly, Captain. After your impressive work at Hosnian Prime, this should be an effortless mission for you, Pilot.
Should be.
Yes. My faith in you was not misplaced. Make sure it stays that way. That will be all.
Okay. What have you got to say?
It's good to see Admiral Sloan's spy network is intact. We can't operate in the dark. Half of the Empire's fracturing is down to commanders operating in isolation, without a grander strategy. They forget we're all one Empire, or should be. Perhaps annihilating this Starhawk will bring us together. You see Admiral Sloan's overall goal, yes? Unify, purify, and inspire. When we defeat this new Republic, we'll have survived the Crucible and come out stronger for it. On to bigger things.
All right. Let's see what Von Reg has to say, I guess.
The captain has a personal stake in Project Starhawk, a vendetta with Lyndon Javes. Take it from me, nothing motivates like betrayal. I've seen too many good pilots. Friends turned traitor. I put them out of their misery. But there's always more out there. Aiden Versia, Erica Quell, Lyndon Javes. They're not just traitors. They're loose ends. Problems to solve once the war is done. We should go.
So yeah, it looks like... I like how this is adding some backstory.
A simple in and out mission should be painless for us. But stay on your toes. You never know what cheap tricks the rebels will pull. De Sevro. Long way from civilization. I haven't seen the Outer Rim since the insurrection at Krigo. Well, let's get to it then. Get to your tie.
So that's what you're having me fly. Okay.
The TIE Reaper's a specialist mode, made for utility and squadron support. If the enemy sees one, they know they're in trouble. With this loadout, it's built to disable enemy fighters with ion lasers. I've also equipped jamming tech to keep you off enemy radars, and tactical shields to protect allied TIEs.
Okay. I am in the full support role this time.
Oh. All this wreckage. What happened here?
Captain Amos is bloodthirsty. He's baited the rebels into pointless fleet battles over De Sevro.
And lost several destroyers by the look of it. At least his recklessness allows us to stay hidden.
We're off their radar.
Stay together and keep your distance. The convoy can't know we're tracking them.
Yes, sir. Let's use those debris clusters as cover and close in on the convoy. But don't boost your engines. It puts the entire mission at risk to fly so brash.
How smart.
Titan 3's radar jammer will make it harder for the enemy to track you. Use it wisely. Just to protect rebel engineers. Why not destroy them? Stop those gearheads from reaching their destination.
Patience, Von Reg. We'll have plenty of new targets once we locate Project Starhawk.
Yes, sir. You're right. It's smarter to hit them at the source than slow them down. Okay. Let's get closer. Take cover in that debris.
I'm missing... There we are. Oh, that's a meter until we're detected.
You're approaching too quickly.
Overseer, we're in position.
Titan. Patience. Remember what we learned at the Battle of Vashar?
How could I forget? We strike when the moment is right, not simply because we can.
We can't lose this convoy. Titan, shoot down the Tormentor's missiles. Captain Amos, you are compromising a delicate mission.
Delicate? This is war. Snuffing out this new republic is the only mission.
Take out the missiles!
Dumbass.
That colossal idiot.
Convoy's alerted to our presence. No way we'll track that junk now.
Better luck next time.
Captain Amos, this is foolish. The Tormentor is severely damaged.
It's still capable of destroying a few rebel ships. Just look at the wreckage around you.
I see TIE fighters out there. Shattered, broken. Yours, I assume.
Every victory has its price.
Convoy's hit.
Shields on you.
Stay focused. Stop that scattered convoy.
I'm hit. Impressive.
The convoy is getting hammered.
I thought you'd let that one land and give them a scare.
That missile made contact.
Actually, wouldn't it make more sense for us to pretend we're...
That missile made contact. Saving the rebels from Imperial missiles. If the enemy thinks we're saviors now, it won't last long. The convoy is getting hammered. Sharpshooting. Captain Amos must be cursing your name. Convoy's hit!
So close.
Practice makes perfect.
Throwing hard!
That's the last of the missiles.
Amos knows he's wasting his time. Good work, Titan. Rebel transports are headed toward the Overseer. They'll jump to hyperspace before our iron cannons can engage. You must stop them, Titan.
Titan, X-Wing's on radar. Titan 3, disable the convoy ships with your ion lasers. We'll cover you.
I'd say you owe me one.
Taking damage. Starfighter, following me.
Oh, come on. Yeah, from checkpoint. It's frustrating. Every now and then, it...
Rebel transports are headed toward the Overseer. They'll jump to hyperspace before our iron cannons can engage. You must stop them, Titan.
Titan, X-Wing's on radar. Titan 3, disable the convoy ships with your ion lasers. We'll cover you.
Attacking your target.
Lucky I was here.
Excellent. Captain Carroll, the transports have been disabled.
Excellent. I'm deploying lander shuttles to board them and seize their nav data.
We'll keep the shuttles safe.
See that you do. Thanks to Captain Amos, physically retrieving the nav data is our last chance at finding Project Starhawk.
Tactical shields got you covered.
Joining up.
Maybe we can give them a hand with...
Buy your tie to the shuttles now.
More rebel fighters inbound.
Portable, yeah. Alright, I know that.
Tactical shields to protect our shuttles.
Wait for me to reload.
Shuttle destroyed. We lost our shuttle.
They destroyed our shuttles. The mission is lost.
shuttle's reached. Let's move.
All right.
More rebel fighters inbound.
Don't let them destroy that.
Information and ready.
Deploy tactical shields to protect our shuttles.
Good shot. Now we've finished them. Shield the shuttle, Titan 3.
Yep.
Protect that.
There we are.
On your wing. Enemy fighter destroyed.
Need a shield? It's yours.
Really?
Overseer, ready to receive shuttle team. Titan 3, keep them safe. Titan, the rebels have scrambled another fighter squadron. They're truly desperate now.
We'll finish off their fighters. Titan 3, defend the shuttles.
Yep, I'm on it.
Threat's gone. Keep fighting.
I suppose I should thank you.
Successful ion attack.
Use this shield well.
Shuttle destroyed.
I want that gone.
Watch behind. Enemies closing.
Keep it up.
Here, have a shield.
Thank you.
now that I actually have an understanding of how the ion weapons work, I might start implementing more loadouts with them. Did I lose a shuttle? I think I lost a shuttle.
Data is safely aboard the Overseer. Decrypting it now. Captain, the Tormentor is taking heavy fire. Its destruction is imminent.
That fool! Titan, return to the Tormentor and cover its retreat.
Yes, ma'am.
Call off your squadron. I don't need their help.
Then you're prepared to retreat?
Never.
You will not survive. Captain Amos.
Watch me.
Amos, you're...
Captain Carol, that frigate is coming apart. The Tormentor is too close.
Amos, evasive maneuvers, now.
What are you talking about?
The frigate is about to explode.
But I won.
We weren't in time.
He's dead. What a waste. At least we have what we came for.
Oh well. He won't be missed.
Titan, we've recovered the sector coordinates for the Starhawk dockyards, but the rest of the data banks are empty.
Engineers must have wiped the rest when Captain Amos blew our cover.
They were so close. An idiot Amos deserves to go down with his ship.
Knowing the sector at least narrows our search. Linden can't hide forever. Titan, eliminate the convoy. Let Linden know we're coming for him.
Oh, but I did finish that one in under 15 minutes, but I didn't do anything else. What did I need for ionizer? Yeah, I only got one, then fucked it up. Yeah. I'll have to eventually play through the campaign again.
For you back at the dockyards. Instead, I had to hang out with a bunch of engineers. They told me a whole convoy of new engineers got intercepted by the Empire. No survivors. Sounds like they had someone on the inside at Hosnian Prime. Give them all the details. As you can imagine, everyone at the dockyard is pretty spooked.
Yeah.
I got a Pazok game planned for them later to help boost morale. Gotta do our part, right? Say, between us, something's up. Something bigger than missing engineers. Ardo ain't talking, and the boss has been shut up in the briefing room all day. I feel like he'd tell us if it was just about the lost engineers. Nah, this is something else. My money's on some kind of unfinished business, like a dark secret he left behind when he skipped out on the Empire. Or not. What would I know, huh? Whatever it is, it's gotta be something he can't fix with a giant battleship. Why don't you head up to the briefing room? The boss might open up to you.
Okay. Anybody? No. Oh.
You're right, Lyndon. The contacts verified your suspicions. It's her.
I knew it could only be Teresa Carroll.
Her mark is all over these attacks.
We know her style.
You do realize there's only one reason she would attack Hosni and Prime in the engineering convoy.
She's searching for Project Starhawk. That's why I've already taken steps to stop her. Before she can find the Nadiri dockyards. Before anyone else gets hurt.
Lyndon. What have you done?
Relax, Otto. All I did was send Teresa a message. One she can't ignore.
What message was that?
An old protege of mine, Teresa Carroll, is leading the Empire's search for Project Starhawk. She won't stop until it's destroyed. So I've initiated a plan. I sent a message that we know was intercepted by an Imperial listening post hidden near Essilis.
What was the message?
Bait for Teresa. And now that the Imperial post has served its purpose, we're ready for part two. If we destroy that listening post, Teresa will think we have something to hide and follow that message to the letter. Vanguard, I want you to take Y-Wings with heavy ordnance to that post in Essilis and bomb it to oblivion. A corvette will join you to draw Imperial fire. Gunny will support and resupply our bombers. These are your targets. We've identified the receivers along the hull as weaker areas. Destroy them all. Additionally, destroy the thermal regulation systems along the exterior trench and any dishes atop the listening post. If you pull this off, we'll rob the Empire of a valuable asset, and then Teresa will fall right into our trap. Teresa Carroll was my second in command at Fostar Haven. She was my protege. She's gone from a Coruscant street orphan to captaining her own Star Destroyer. The Empire gave her everything, and she'll do anything to defend it. That's why I'm keeping certain details quiet. With Teresa in the game, any leak is a risk. Just trust me a little longer.
Okay.
Head to the hangar. Zerelda should have your ship almost ready.
I have to say, the commander's plan is quite clever. All this secrecy and subterfuge, it's almost imperial. I know the New Republic strives to be better than the Empire, but you must admit their tactics are effective. Not that we should adopt them, of course, but this is war. Sometimes you have to think like your enemy in order to defeat them. We're lucky the commander is using his tactical brilliance for our side. Let's focus on the mission.
Alright. So we should be flying. Yeah, we are flying a Y-Wing now. What have you got to say about this, Keo?
When Javes talks about Carol, you can feel it, right? He must have cared about her greatly to feel such pain. I don't think it's a coincidence that the Empire sent Teresa after Javes. This feels personal. They must both be hurting. And hurt can so easily turn to hate. Hate that cannot be healed has no place in the galaxy. If fighting it has become the only option, so be it. Are you ready?
Yeah, you seem pretty calm about it all, though. Alright.
Y-Wings are built to carry bombs and other heavy explosives. It makes them slower, but they pack a punch against large targets and capital ships.
Alright. Goliath missile. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I'll take
guaranteed to satisfy
that, and then Starfire takes much less damage from lasers. And we'll go with that one. There we go. That way, no matter what, we'll be able to get boosts going. I really like the guided cannon, though. Okay, now we're set. We're slower, but now we have a little bit more oomph.
But it isn't the last listening post eavesdropping on the galaxy. Well, they do seem hell-bent on finding us. I bet the Empire cannot stand that we're building a new ship out of their old ones.
There's our listening post. I'll jam Imperial sensors on approach. I love it. They'll never see us coming. Let's make them regret eavesdropping on the New Republic, huh? Just like that, we're hidden from Imperial sensors. Follow me, Five. We'll lead the bombing run.
Got it.
Grace and I will take care of station defenses and starfighter patrols.
Here we go, Five. Give them everything you got. Good, you're almost there. On my mark, it's bombs away.
Finish him off.
done for. Not yet. Reloading.
That leaves plenty of time to take out the communications array.
You're good now. Regroup when you're ready, Five.
That's half of it. Okay.
Right here and ready to go.
General distress call to any Imperial forces. SLS 337 is under attack. Reinforce immediately.
Ah, heck. Sounds like Imperial backup is on the way.
We were too late. That's fine. Taking out the dishes.
Shit. So we just gotta go through each of their trench sections and destroy those conduits? That's not too bad.
Stay okay back there, buddy.
I gotcha. We got a lot more ties inbound. Our Corvette is taking heavy fire. Get in there and help them out, Five.
Oh.
Thermal system destroyed. Temperatures are rising.
Vanguard, the Empire just opened a massive vent on the listening post. The thermal systems must be overloading. They're trying to cool down the core.
Regroup at the vent. I got an idea.
Heads up. I got eyes on ties.
Alright.
We need you at the vent.
That's where I'm trying to get to. Okay, so we're gonna go through it. Got it. Doing what you were telling me to do, damn it.
Fly carefully.
We all believe in you, Five.
When you get to the core, start dropping bombs and do not stop. You won't have much time to get out once the core explodes, so be ready to fly fast. Drop your bombs, Five.
Closing. Go, go, go!
Ooh. Okay. That almost reminded me of the Station Destruction of Shadows of the Empire game. Just not quite as much to it. I am glad that there's no third-person camera option for this game. Yeah, Corvette and figures. I'm not trying to go for the efficiency medals, I'm just trying to enjoy the missions. I think we'll go ahead and do one more mission before we call it a night.
All I'm saying is, instead of blowing up that listening post, we should have commandeered it. Imagine the kind of fun we could have had messing with the Imperials, or the credits we could make.
As your squad leader, I'm gonna pretend I didn't just hear that.
Come on, Gunny. You telling me the New Republic couldn't use more intel? And you know war ain't cheap.
Actually, that's a good point. I guess once you steal a Star Destroyer, everything Imperial starts to look tempting.
You know, we used to be rebels. We turned into a legit republic, and suddenly we all gotta stay on the straight and narrow.
The commander's lining up a trap for Teresa Carroll. That's not enough of a con for you?
In the old days, I'd trick her for everything but a pair of boots to stand in.
Yeah.
I guess this'll do.
Well, when he's right, he's right. Now, how about we get some actual work done?
Alright, so what's our...
Congratulations. Because you captured the Star Destroyer Victorum, our Starhawk prototype has been completed ahead of schedule. But the Empire does not know that. They believe it's still under construction. Teresa Carroll will keep hunting Project Starhawk until it's destroyed. And we've been assigned to stop her.
Okay.
So, using that decoy message I sent, we're going to set up an ambush. The false intel stated that you're protecting a shipment of magnite crystals essential to completing the Starhawk. With this bait, we'll draw Teresa and the Overseer deep into the Xavian Abyss, a highly volatile area of space. Here is where we set our trap. Don't worry about the convoy. It's empty and droid piloted. However, that does mean you'll need to clear any obstructions from its path. Vanguard, I want you to defend that convoy with everything you've got. We need to make this look good.
Alright.
Our destination is this bottleneck. There, the Starhawk will be waiting to disable the Overseer. And hopefully, capture Teresa.
Ooh.
It might sound simple, but nothing is simple in the Xavian Abyss. Brace yourselves.
I like the idea, though.
If Lyndon's right, this plan could knock Teresa Carroll off our tail. Sooner the better, if you ask me. Lyndon's convinced himself that he's put us in danger. Yeah. I can't make him focus on the bigger picture while Teresa's still in it. The commander's a smart man, but everyone has someone who can push their buttons. I wonder if we can push hers, too. We'll give Teresa a harmless convoy to follow, play this out, and see just how far we can lead her. It's all about playing the long game. When the Empire occupied Mon Cala, I learned how to string Imperials along. If you seem harmless, people underestimate you. I spent a lot of time around Imperials, playing the dumb alien, a bartender, a sweeper, someone safe. Next day, The Rebellion would know everything I'd overheard. It wasn't easy, but I learned to stay patient and wait for opportunities. Remember, the Xavian Abyss is no place for the faint-hearted. And Teressa knows a few tricks of her own. Keep your eyes and ears open, all right?
Okay. What about you, Javes?
And Starhawk's crew?
More than ready. I selected the crew personally based on their expertise and experience. They've been training for months.
That's good. I appreciate your support on this, General.
It's a good plan, Lyndon. Just be careful. I know you have a past with the Overseer's captain. Don't let it cloud your judgment.
One moment, General. Sorry. I can't talk right now. Your squadron is waiting.
Okay. But it's interesting that we also get a chance to see Hera involved in this.
So, the boss wants to pull the old bait and switch on Teressa. I must be rubbing off on him.
I know, sounds like
a good con is selling it. And going into the Xavian Abyss, well, either you're too naive to know better, or you think it's worth the risk. Like, say, stopping a Starhawk from being finished. Teressa Carroll's risking the Abyss just for the chance to destroy some magnite crystals. Ain't she in for a surprise? I'm kind of excited to see our Starhawk tackle Teressa's flagship. All those engineers worked their tails off to get it finished. That's one good thing about this new Republic. We're finally punching at the same weight as the Empire. One way or another, this is gonna be a show.
I've heard tales of the Xavian Abyss. They say it's swallowed entire fleets without a trace. Sending our brand new Starhawk in there is quite the gamble. Commander Javes must have complete faith in its builders. And in us, of course. We'll be the ones making this ruse work, after all. I took the liberty of studying the Starhawk's blueprints. It's not just another capital ship. It's a defense against Imperial fleets. Every spare inch is packed with lasers and munitions, but what really caught my eye was the tractor beam.
Oh?
If I understood the blueprints, the Starhawk's tractor beam is 10 times more powerful than that of a Star Destroyer.
So, it should be able to hold a Star Destroyer in place.
The crystals they use in the Starhawk's tractor beam are quite rare. I think they salvaged a few from the Star Destroyer we captured. My family spent an exorbitant amount of credit sourcing magnite crystals. It's so gratifying to see them go to a good cause. Let's put our new Starhawk through its paces, shall we?
Okay. Interesting. Anybody else for us to speak with? Nope. So...
you got your choice of fighters for this mission. An X-Wing, Y-Wing, or A-Wing. They've all got pros and cons. Check the schematics and let me know what'll suit you. Guaranteed to satisfy.
Let's see. That might... considering we'll have a capital ship to deal with. Probably want that. We'll keep those. We'll go for a heavier hull. A little bit more powerful shields and... there we go. Go with just a nice X-Wing for this. And we actually have a pretty balanced loadout they give us.
As you can see, I wasn't exactly...
exaggerating about the dangers of the Xavian Abyss.
Ooh.
Yeah. Look at that lightning. And we got word that Teresa Carroll has taken the bait. Her flagship Overseer is closing in. Good luck, Vanguard. Protect that convoy. And see you on the other side.
You can feel it, right? Chaos on every side. We don't belong here.
I'd hate to see what it does.
Hey, what happens once the Starhawk disables the Overseer? The same as the Victorum, I expect. Board it, lock its systems, and take the crew prisoner.
I don't know, Grace. I can't imagine Teresa Carroll coming along quietly. I hate these clouds. Who knows what's out there?
We know what's out there. A Star Destroyer with a captain who wants us dead.
Real helpful. Thanks, Gunny.
That is just...
Convoy's droid autopilot ain't smart enough to steer through these asteroids.
Then let's blast them a path.
All right.
Wait, look. A Star Destroyer. Or what's left of one.
I'd say it's been here a long while.
You'd think this would discourage Teresa Carroll.
Someone like her, that wreckage ain't a warning. It's one more insult.
So we'll just go ahead and keep our shields overcharged. Back here. They probably don't, but
keep flying.
Hip. I'm getting out of it. Come on. Let's go. Alright, there should only just be the couple left, right?
You're in the clear.
Hit it.
Five, stay on course.
Okay, you guys have them all in the clouds though, so. Storm fully shuts down my weapons.
I repeat, Vandar, the Imperials scanned the convoy, but the Overseer is still on approach. They must have stopped the TIEs before they could transmit that scan. Vandar,
signal's breaking up. Let's push on.
The ambush point is this way. Ready? Let's go.
Alright, I'm kind of curious about how big Starhawk actually is. Like this.
If we don't destroy the asteroids, the Overseer will catch the convoy.
Yes, Teresa decided to handle this convoy herself. I got the cold sweat on my neck.
Stay focused.
Focused on the Star Destroyer right behind me. I'm trapped with nowhere to go. Launch fighters!
More Imperial fighters! Check behind! Focus on the bombers!
You got a lock on me!
Alright.
I'm with you!
Okay.
We can make it to the bottleneck in time. We will. We just have to push forward.
That's an enemy lock on. Enemies destroyed.
Let's get some fire on that.
You see that shot? Cassier is targeting you. I need more time. Distract your missile while we charge the tractor beam. And stay alive.
Easier said than done.
Captain Carroll to Vanguard Squadron. This is a futile gesture. You have nowhere to go, and I have no interest in prisoners. Shield at zero.
Interceptors are really tough to stay on. Okay.
What's wrong, Teresa? Can't hit something that ain't a helpless convoy?
Tractor beams at 61%.
I'm in their sights.
Tractor beam at 87%. Ready to trap.
Oh, that is big. That is really big.
The scan worked, Titan. That convoy's navicomputer had the sector and system we've been looking for. We've got them right where we want them.
Oh, it's a straight up ramming ship, I think.
Titan, return to the Overseer for immediate hyperspace jump.
We can't jump that fast. We could end up in the middle of a star or worse.
Stay and we die for sure.
Fighters don't make it.
Well, we know this Starhawk works.
Toss the Overseer around like a low threat.
Good. Now the Imperials deserve payback with interest.
Shall we just build a Death Star and get it over with?
Grace, we're still the good guys. Anyhow, we won, right? Wherever they jumped, no ship's coming back from that.
Let's hope so.
Yeah, that tractor beam was so strong, though, it was literally tearing the Star Destroyer apart. Oh, wow. Shot down three missiles. We did it that fast?
Where are we?
Alpha Rem, Remetic system, grid L42.
Scramble fire crews. Get a distress call to the nearest Imperial station.
Aha! There's an old munitions depot in this system, Captain, run by a Colonel Grom. Must be our lucky day.
Make the call. This isn't over, thank God.
So, you jump to my territory, uninvited, then demand my supplies?
Colonel Grom, the Starhawk project is within our grasp. All I need is repairs and proper munitions.
No. The Emperor assigned me to this depot. I decide how its resources are used. As of this moment, that includes your Star Destroyer. Consider yourself reassigned.
The Overseer was sent on this mission by Admiral Sloan herself.
Admiral Sloan isn't here, Captain. I have rebel guerrillas to deal with. And now, so do you. Grom out.
Oh, okay.
He wants us to fight rebels. All right. We'll protect his depot. And if his munitions get lost in the crossfire, well, lucky for us.
Ma'am, regulations specifically forbid this.
I will not be beaten by Vanguard, grandstanding imbeciles, or anyone else.
Please, not judgment.
It's just fine. Call in Titan Squadron. Now!
Okay.
Could we talk?
So we're going to go ahead and call it a night there. Story's actually getting really good. I might actually, instead of tomorrow's normal scheduled Metal Gear Survive, just continue with this. We'll see. But story's starting to get pretty good, and I want to make sure I have enough of the story itself before we just focus purely on the multiplayer aspect of it. But yeah, if you've enjoyed the stream and are not already following, please go ahead and leave a follow, and I hope to see everybody again next time. Have a wonderful evening.